memories. A group of friends going down the river in different kinds of tubes. Okay. There's a people tube. And a tube that can hold a cooler in it, which is probably red. That's very often red. Oh,
Stuart, I'm not gonna lie to you. This is actually a very, very good drawing.
Stuart,
especially on that.
Where did you take classes? Oh, Nelly.
What's your heart?
Math teacher.
You both?
Just because you're math teacher doesn't mean you can't be an art teacher.
So there's not just one person in one cooler, but several people. It's probably several coolers. Day-long trip down the river. Company, river trip. Okay, $15 to rent a tube. So one of these, one of those costs $15.
$15.
These cooler tubes cost $7.50. And what else do we know? We know that they rented a bunch of tubes and a bunch of cooler tubes, and they spent $360. Is that it? Oh, a total of 26 tubes. Like, the combination of these kinds and these kinds is 26 tubes altogether. What this river is made of, that it's orange. It's blue. I'm not green.
Stuart.
Yes?
Wait, we did the stuff.
Teaching class right now.
Okay, so they rented 26 tubes altogether. The whole thing, the whole ordeal costs $360. Okay, the thing that people often struggle with is they try to put too much into one equation, two different equations. Okay. So if we call the number of cooler, well, maybe regular tubes, we'll call them X. Okay, X is the number of people tubes. Y is the number of cooler tubes. Not tubes that are cooler, but tubes that carry coolers. So let's write two equations. Both obviously going to involve x and y in some way. What? So what equation can we write involving x, y, and equations together? X being the number of people tubes, and y is the number of cooler tubes.
I need an agenda. Have you found one?
No.
A new agenda?
No, I need my agenda.
Oh. So if you need a new agenda, just wait for someone.
You have things to do today, and very few of them have to do with finding Wyatt's agenda. Let's write an equation that has to do with x and y. Think about, okay, x is the number of cooler tubes, or of people tubes. Okay, so x is all these people tubes, and y is these cooler tubes. Okay. What do I know about the number of people tubes and the number of cooler tubes? So I can Well, we're not told that there is, but I'm just assuming. That might be a way that we could make sense of the answer. Does this answer make sense? I think that it would come out like this. Okay, the goal is just, yeah, we know that they spent $360 on X number of people tubes and Y number of cooler tubes.
Would be like 15 to X and 750 to Y.
15 times x, 15 times a people tube, right? Or 15 times two people tubes, or two people tubes, x people tubes, plus 750 times y cooler tubes. When we add up all that money, it should come up to how much?
360.
equation, and it probably is going to use information we have not yet used in an equation. What have we not used in one of the in this equation? 26.
X plus Y equals 26.
X plus Y equals 26. The number of people tubes plus the number of cooler tubes is 26. We're going to use substitution. Like this guy is going to be really easy to get y or x, our choice, by itself. We'll just go ahead and subtract y from both sides, and now x is equal to 26 minus y. And so now we don't need that equation. It's been rewritten and made into this equation. Now what do we do then? Now that we have x is equal to 26 minus y.
Distribute, like you put 26 minus y where the x is.
Yeah. Right, we take the x away, and we completely just replace it with 26 minus y, because they're the same, so they're interchangeable, so we interchange them. Now we have an equation that only has the y variable in it. And now we
distribute.
We'll distribute the 15 times 26. I'll do it if everybody else does. 15 times 26. 390 minus 15y. Plus 7.5y equals 360. Now what, Rami?
Like terms.
Okay, what do you mean by that?
15 and 7.5.
So negative 15y plus 7.5y is negative 7.5y. So 390 minus 7.5y equals 360.
Minus 390.
Minus 390. We're going to wind up with a negative over here. Negative 7.5y equals negative 30. So they're divided, you say? By
7.5.
Divide by negative 7.5. I hope I divide by a negative, right? Because I have a negative over here, and negative by negative is positive. We're going to have a positive number of twos.
Y equals,
so negative 30 divided by negative 7.5 is the same as 30 divided by 7.5, because it's going to be positive. Or.
I was going to say that.
Good job, David. Y is for. Let's see what y is for means. What does y is for mean? What does y represent?
Tubes.
Which ones? Which tubes?
The cooler ones.
The cooler ones. We wrote it down at the very beginning. Y is the number of cooler tubes.
Oh, really?
So, four of those. Four cooler tubes. Well, we know they rented 26 tubes, right? And four of them were cooler tubes, and how many of them were regular people tubes?
22,
right? Four of those were cooler tubes, 22 of them were people tubes. So 22 people tubes and four cooler tubes. Well, 36 next. So Laura has $4.50. Please stop having side conversations. So she has $4.50, made completely of what kinds of coins?
Quarters and dimes.
Quarters and dimes, so she's only got quarters and dimes, keep that in mind. She has three more
and quarters,
maybe. Three more dimes than quarters. Three more dimes than quarters. And that's all the information they gave us. So maybe we should give names like X and Y. What should X represent?
Dimes.
4.5 rows.
Dimes. The number of dimes. So what would Y represent?
Number of quarters.
Number of quarters. So using this information that they give us, and probably some information we already have, like a quarter is worth how much?
25.
And a dime is worth 10 cents, right? So information they didn't give us, we just know it, because we use those coins quite a bit. We need to write equations incorporating this information. She has a total of $4.50, and she has three more dimes and quarters. So what equation is going to be right that involve the number of quarters and the number of dimes?
10 cents minus 25 cents equals 50.
10 cents plus 25 cents equals $4.50?
Yeah.
You write that equals 35 cents?
Yeah.
So I think that we're getting somewhere, not quite there, because that equals 35 cents, not 450.
Wait, can you do it like this way? Like, think of it again.
Okay.
Just like in my mind. So, like, I forgot.
What are you supposed to
do? I'll go back.
You don't know.
More.
So, just three more dimes.
So, like, if quarters are 10 cents, I mean, quarters are 25 cents, and dimes are like 10 cents.
Yeah.
And then you do 25 minus 10, which is like 15, I'm pretty sure. And then 15 divided by there's three more dimes is 5.
Oof. You're kind of doing, you're kind of like trying to do the substitution in your head. I'm not sure if you're right.
Plug in her 5.
Mm-hmm.
Her 5. Mm-hmm.
Just don't see. A little something missing there. But in any case, we're supposed to write. Supposed to get practice writing two equations and put them together. You may have heard of something like what you have, but then also a little bit more.
Does it have to be three more dimes than quarters? Like, could it be 5 dimes more?
It has to be three more dimes than quarters. It's got to be three more dimes than quarters. Well, this is a lot like the tube problem. It's like you're buying several quarters and several dimes, right? And it adds up to a total dollar amount. Right? Every dime is worth 10 cents, so 10 cents times the number of dimes is the value of all the dimes. And 25 cents times the number of quarters is the total value of all of the quarters. Add up those two values, you get 450. Okay. There are three more dimes and quarters. Let me just throw this out there. First of all, what's there more of, dimes or quarters?
Three more dimes, because you got three more dimes and quarters.
Okay. It's a good question to ask yourself, because those are the kinds of things, when I was learning to write these equations, I would get that stuff backwards. I know there's like a plus 3 involved, but I would add the 3 to the wrong thing. So keep in mind that there's more dimes than quarters. So if I tell you, hypothetically, that there's 10 quarters, then how many dimes would there have to be? So if there's 15 quarters, how many dimes would there have to be?
18.
Thank you. Switch it up on you. If I told you that there were 14 dimes, not quarters, 14 dimes, how many quarters?
11
quarters. Okay, so we have a way to go from quarters to dimes, right? We just need to write an equation. If I had the number of, let's say, quarters, okay, if I had the number of quarters, what would I do to the quarters to figure out the dimes?
Minus, you would. So you know the number of quarters,
add 3
dimes to it.
We add 3 to it, and that would give us the dimes, right? Add 3 to it, you get the number of dimes.
Mm-hmm.
Number of quarters plus 3, just an arbitrary 3, and you get the number of dimes.
16,
10, 25, $4. Okay. Now we use substitution. It's all set up because it says x is equal to y plus 3. So we'll replace this x with y plus 3. 0.10 times x, which is the same as y plus 3, plus 0.25y equals 4.5.
If I turn an assignment and have a question mark next to a question, like, be marked off, you would help me.
If you didn't do anything, you would.
No, I mean, if
yes.
If I write down the problem and stuff and like, write down a question mark, it's like, would you have marked it off?
More than that, even just a little bit
well,
more.
Well, the question mark just means to come, it's like, I need help with that.
You need help with that?
Okay.
All right. So we replace this x with y plus 3 because x and y plus 3 are the same according to this equation. So what do we do to figure out what y is? Solve this equation. Follow your bliss here. What does your heart say to do?
Get rid of y.
Distribute.
Distribute. I like distribute. So 0.10y plus 0.3 plus 0.25y equals 4.5.
Mr. Stewart, you're so wizard without even looking at
the That's awesome.
He's looking at the over there.
Oh crap, come on. I'm just watching him. Just.
All right, so we have 0.1y and 0.25y. We can write, add them together, 0.35y plus 0.3 equals 4.5. Okay. So we combine like terms, 0.35y plus 0.3 equals 4.5. So we want to get, we want to solve y, get y by itself. So we would do what?
Well, you can't combine like that.
No, we did that.
There
we go, subtract 0.3, right? Get that constant out of there. 0.35y equals
4.2.
And then?
I think that was a 5. That was one. A 5.
What was?
4.5.
So it was, when I subtracted 0.3,
we
got 4.2. Do what now?
Divide
by 0.35. We divide by 4.2 by 0.35.
Are you sure?
So what is 12? We have 12 of what?
12 of quarters.
Let's see, we wrote it down up here. Y is the number of quarters. So we have 12 of quarters.
12.
Right. Now, if you were reading the question, really, really strictly.
Nice.
The number of quarters is the question. How many quarters are there? That's it. So we have 12 quarters. Math, you have times where you could say 15, I added 3, I got 3. Writing the equations is probably the trickiest part. Okay. But if you're having trouble, you could kind of, as long as you establish what x and y are, number of quarters and dimes, all this guessing that all are really tempted to do,
you
can use that. You can use that to your advantage to write these equations, right? Because when you make those guesses, and you check and see if it works, you're essentially using an equation without realizing it. If I were to guess that there were 9 dimes, right? Well, if I guess that there's 9 dimes, I know how many quarters there would have to be, right? Because how many would there have to be? If there's 9 dimes, how many quarters would there have to be?
There's 12 quarters.
Huh?
No quarters.
You have to
like pretend you don't know that.
Oh.
If I just guess that there's 9 dimes, how many quarters would that be?
Well, you have 3 more dimes than quarters,
yeah.
So you have to Six.
That'd be six. Okay. So do you see how you're using this equation? Where do you go? Right here. Without realizing. So try several guesses, but don't just stay there. Don't just only ever guess and then figure out the answer that way. Try to practice a new skill. We're trying to practice a new skill. That is challenging. But we can use our guesses to write the equations. If you guess at the number of quarters, and the number of dimes, think about how you're checking that. Are you checking it against the value? Okay, then you've got the ingredients for writing that equation. Because what you're going to do in order to check that it adds up to 450 is take 10 cents times the number of dimes plus 25 cents times the number of quarters and see if it adds up to 450. Since you're doing that, you have the equation, you just need to kind of draw it out of your mind. And you're checking it against this fact here to see if there's three more quarters, or three more dimes and quarters, then you have the ingredients to write this equation. Whatever you're doing to your specific guesses, that's what you would still do to the variables in your equations. There's not a lot to this but to practice it over and over and over. Well, here we go. So we're talking about this girl. She's buying tubes of paint. So let's draw tubes of paint. Okay. How much do tubes of paint cost?
$3.
$3. Also buying brushes.
$0.50.
If that was all we knew, that wouldn't be enough, right? We would just have the prices of two items in a store. We know that she spends $16 total. That's the receipt. What she gets at the end is $16. And also, what else do we know? Rami, just come sit right over here. Start with, let's first ask, are there more brushes or are there more tubes of paint?
More brushes.
There are more brushes, and how do you know that?
Because it says there's twice as many.
Because it says there's twice as many brushes as tubes of paint. Okay? So, I'm going to guess, okay? Or I'm just going to say that there are, in an effort to write this first equation, let's say that she bought 8 tubes of paint. Then what do you know for
brushes.
Sure?
16 brushes.
Okay, let's take another guess. Let's write things down. X is going to represent something. Y is going to represent something. What's X going to represent?
Brushes.
The number of brushes.
I did it right.
Changed our minds. Tubes.
I did tubes too.
And Y is representing?
Brushes.
And the brush. So, we said she bought 8 tubes, and that means she must have bought
16
brushes. Let's just try one more before we finalize this into the equation. If she bought 7 tubes of paint, 14 brushes. So, if she bought X tubes of paint, what would I do with the number of tubes of paint to find the brushes? Double it, and it will get you the number of brushes. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Double it, and you find the number of brushes. That's one equation, 2x equals y. Now we need to write another equation, probably going to do with the dollar amounts. Let's say that she did buy 7 tubes and 14 brushes. I want you to check and see if that's right. Is it right that she would have bought 7 shoes and 14 brushes, or is that guess wrong? How do we check and see whether it's right or wrong that she bought 7 tubes of paint and 14 brushes?
Make an equation and, like, put the numbers in there.
Because 7 times 3, 14 times 5.
And why are you doing that?
Because 2 is $3, and it can't equal more than $16.
Okay, so he's checking to see if it adds up to $16. Okay? And I think, like, we all get how to check that answer, right? But turning into an equation is the thing we're working on here. So, if I take 7 tubes times $3 plus 14 brushes times 50 cents, what should it come out to be?
16.
And if it does, well, then we guessed right. But I guess wrong on purpose. But does it come out to be 16? What does it come out to be? 21, that's already
$28.
21 plus 7 more. So, no, right?
Nope.
It is not correct. But if I just erase these values here and try another guess, right? I can just change out those numbers and see what the total comes out to be. Try 9 and 7, except for, well, we know that it should, like, if this were 9, right, if it was 9 tubes, then it should be 18 brushes, right, because we doubled it. But whatever the number of tubes is, I'll take it and multiply by 3. What?
All right, so let's move it back here.
And I'll take the number of brushes and multiply that by 50 cents, and it should come out to be how much?
Oh, I'll be 350.
How much should the, when I add up all the dollar amounts, it should come out to do what?
$16.
We have both of our, I should write this equation a little better. 3x plus 0.5y equals 16. 3 and 6. All right. This equation's a nice one. Can we all please direct our attention to the board here, please? Hear other people talking. I don't have to look at them. I can hear them. So this equation is nice because it tells us that y is the same as 2x. So this can be replaced with what?
2x.
So 3x plus 0.5 times 2x equals 16. 3x plus 0.5 times 2.
$1.
1, yeah, 1x, right? 1 times x. 3x plus x is
4x.
Divide by 4?
4.
So what's 4 about this scenario?
That is x, and so that means y.
But what does x mean? She bought 4 tubes of paint. We wrote that down right there. If she bought 2, or sorry, bought 4 tubes of paint, then how many brushes must she have bought? 8, right? Because she bought double the number of brushes. So 4 tubes, 8 brushes. Yes.
What if I didn't write up the 2 equations, but instead I did 3 word equations, and then I got that final one? It makes sense.
So you have.
And I tried it the first time, and I got success.
Then you're not. I mean, you're getting close, but you're not quite practicing.
But I put it all together. It was just in word form.
Working on the skills of translating words into equations.
I did that.
Stop there.
So actually it doesn't come out to completely 16. It comes out to 15, 15, 15.
Okay, well that's bad. Let's see what we have here. Three times the number of tubes of paint, yeah? Three times four.
Because
plus eight, or sorry, let's say 50
five.
Cents,
yeah.
Times the number of brushes, which we are saying is eight, which Jen is saying is not right. Three times four is 12. 0.5 times eight is what?
30.
No.
It's going to be 16.
0.5 times eight, right? Half of eight?
No, but the brushes cost only 15 cents. I mean, 50 cents.
I know, it's going to make it twice as much if three times
eight. It is four. That does come out to be 16. All right, 50 cents times eight brushes. So like two brushes would be a dollar, right? So two brushes for a dollar.
No, I can't.
So eight brushes for $4.
No, I can't. Yeah, that probably
I wasn't talking.
Yeah, how all that now?
Farther rather than
saying.
Did you see that?
That wasn't me. That was.
Is that what they have here?
You were trying to convince me that that gap's not very big, or
is
that tiny gap?
It's the same thing.
Yes, he does.
You have to. Is this kayaker? Okay, and here's.
You fishing? Or
the best? That's
fast. Okay. It's for fish to hit the power. That's how you go fishing.
Okay, what's the scenario?
We're done talking about fishing, and now we can talk about this kayak.
Okay, the guy with the kayak is doing what?
I'd love to tell you, but I'd love to be the only one talking. So this kayaker, let's pretend she paddles across this pond. So I'm going to refer to her speed in still water. This is what that means. So the speed in still water just means how fast she can paddle without any resistance or any help. So she wants to know how fast she's able to paddle. She forgot to measure while she was at the pond, though, and she went to the river. But what's the thing about a river?
It flows.
If you want to, yeah, it flows. It has a direction that it goes. It has a current, right. So the current is pushing this way, and if she paddles with the current, right, downriver is what that's called, she can paddle 19 miles per hour.
Sweet.
But that doesn't really tell you how fast she's able to paddle. Know that, and we don't know that, right? But what we do know is if she paddles the other way, she can go 5 miles per hour, 5 miles per hour.
That'll just waste my energy.
When she's going against the current, right? And the current's biting against her. So let's talk about X and Y. Let's see if we have an idea of what X and Y you're going to represent.
X, 19, 4, 5,
6. So we don't care about this, and all you're doing is disrupting everybody else. So it goes to the So what might X represent in this scenario? Since it's, you know, talking about all these things that we know, these things that we don't know.
Oh.
What's that now? Well, we know her speed downstream and we know her speed upstream.
Her speed upstream is lane.
Is what?
Lane. It goes pretty slow.
But she's fighting against the river.
I could go faster.
So what could X represent? What are the two things we're trying to figure out? The two things we don't know.
Her
speed that she could paddle in still water, right? So her speed. What else don't we know?
The current.
The river water.
Of the current, yeah, the current's speed. Speed.
What are we going down to?
Of current.
Current.
And, you know, even if only, if all we want to know is how fast she can paddle, we still need to know how fast the river's going.
Right, but we don't know.
But we do know something about her speed with the current and her speed against the current. Right, so there's, you see two scenarios there? Two scenarios, two equations. Right? Somehow, her speed and the current, right, are working together in some way, and together they make 19 miles per hour, and in another way, together they make 5 miles per hour. But think of a way.
Would you subtract 5 from 19?
Let's stop trying to solve the like the problem and try to write, like, let's view this as one equation and this as another equation. Let's try this. Let me give you, like, we'll try the guessing thing. What if she is able to paddle 6 miles per hour, like just in still water. Her speed is 6 miles per hour.
Stop.
If this lady can paddle 6 miles per hour, and we pay attention to this scenario, can you tell me about the speed of the current? If she can paddle 6 miles per hour?
1 mile per hour faster.
Yeah, I use the chart of 19 from 6, and it tells you how fast the current is.
Yeah.
Okay, so how fast is the current in this scenario if she paddles 6 miles per hour? Okay, so if she paddles 6, it's like if x were 6, then y would have to be 13.
Yeah.
Okay, let me throw another possibility out there. What if she's able to paddle 14 miles per hour? Then the speed of the current will be 5. What are you doing with these two numbers?
You're adding.
And you should get?
19.
So, here we go. Her speed plus the current speed.
10 and 9.
Should equal?
19.
Now 10 and 9 is a valid combination. 11 and 8 is a valid combination. 12 and 7 is a valid combination. There's an infinite number of combinations. 15 and a half. And 3.5. Another valid combination.
Yeah,
18, you get that? So that's why we need this second equation. excuse me. If she is able to paddle, you know, based on this scenario, if she's able to paddle 7 miles per hour, then how fast must the current be moving? If she's able to paddle 7 miles per hour, and the current's fighting against her. And she nets a 5 miles per hour. She can paddle 7.
And she's
working against the current, and she's only able to get going 5 miles per hour.
2.
The current must be going the other way too.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody can follow that? She's able to paddle 7. She has the strength to paddle 7 miles per hour. But the current is fighting against her, right? So it's taking away from her speed. And in the end, she's going 5 miles per hour. So that amount of speed that's taking away must be 2 miles per hour. Let's try again. If she can paddle 9 miles per hour, then how fast is the current going?
Four. That's four.
One more, and then we're going to write our equation with this information. Okay, notice that x, I'm going to make x be 15 miles per hour.
Warp 10.
So the current must be going 10. So Remy, how are you coming up with this?
You know, taking the number, which is x, subtract it by 5.
Subtracting 5 from it?
Yeah.
So that's going to be our equation. Take her speed, subtract 5, and you get the speed of the current. What do you think of that?
Looks pretty obvious.
Now, what about this equation? I'm just going to write it this way because it's helpful in our next skill that we're building. What if I take her speed and I subtract the current speed, the speed of the river, what should I get?
10.
Wait. You just
keep should get 5.
You just
should you get 5?
Well,
right.
When, if you're subtracting the current,
mm-hmm.
meaning the lowering the current.
No, I'm taking the speed of the current away from her speed.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that what's happening as she paddles up?
Yeah.
She's paddling this fast, the river goes this fast the other way, it's taking its speed away from her speed, right? So take the river speed away from the kayaker's speed, and you should wind up with a 5 mile per hour speed, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, written this way, it becomes very easy to practice our new skill here, okay? But first, before I just tell you what to do, let's review real quick. What's this thing?
Scale.
It's a scale.
It's a scale, okay? And with a scale or an equation, we always have to, what's like the cardinal rule for equations and scales?
It has to be
input and output.
Whatever you put in must come out.
Okay, we gotta keep it balanced. Let's start with you gotta keep it balanced. So it's gotta stay balanced. So if I put stuff here.
You gotta put stuff on the other side.
Put stuff on the other side. Okay.
That stuff's like when you're distributing, you go whatever you do with one side, you have to do with the other. That thing going on. Right?
So if on this side I put two of these. Right? Put two of these on this side. What do I need to do on the other side?
Put two more.
Two. Now, what if on this side I put two chips? Put two chips on this side, as long as I put something that I know is the same as two chips, right? Is this two chips?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Look at it. Is it two chips?
No.
No, it's a container with some chips in it.
Container with two chips.
But if I put them over here,
they weigh more. Even.
Balanced?
Get wrecked.
So I put two here, and I put. Did I put two chips over here?
Technically you did, but you also.
Technically I did not. Very technically I didn't. Technically I put this container on the
cylinder.
And technically you put two chips inside the container.
Technically I put one inside the container, and the container weighs as much as the chip. So let's just talk about this. We have a scale,
yes.
And on this side I put 5 1-pound weights, okay? 5 weights that each weigh a pound, okay? So on this other side I have to put 5 pounds.
Yes.
Let's say on this side I just put a rock that I know weighs 5 pounds. Will it still be balanced?
Yes, it will be exactly the same.
Okay, so as long as the things we add on both sides, they don't have to necessarily look exactly the same and be exactly the same. But they do have to be exactly equal. Agreed?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, they do have to be exactly equal.
You're equal.
Thank you. Alright. Let me show you my idea. this equation, and remember we have to do the same thing to both sides, agreed?
Yeah.
Or equal things on both sides. On this side, I'm going to add something, just like we talked about adding weights on this side and adding a rock that we know weighs the same amount on the other side. I'm going to add 5 to this side. On this side, I have to add something that's the same as 5, right? Can I agree on that?
Yes, sir.
So on this side, I'm going to add, you might expect me to put 5 there, but I'm going to put x minus y. Is 5 the same as x minus y?
Yeah.
Yes.
They are the same.
Yes.
X minus y is the same as 5. So if I add 5 to this side and x minus y to that 5, that side, I've added equal amounts to both sides. Now let's see why that's good. On this side, when I add 5 to 19, what do I get? 24. Okay. And on this side here, I'm adding up x plus y plus x minus y. Well, the two x's go together.
2x.
2x.
2xy equals 24.
2xy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
Well,
now they
cancel
themselves
out, it's actually
going to
be
2x
equals
24. Right. The y and the negative y
cancel
each other out. Y minus y is 0. 2x equals 24.
12.
And you
so
divide by 2.
So what do we know about this scenario here?
Your speed is 12.
She can paddle 12 miles per hour. And since we know this, so we should know that the speed of the river is what?
Sorry.
Her speed is 12.
Yeah.
And she's paddling down river.
19 miles an hour.
19 miles an hour is the total speed.
She can paddle pretty fast.
Yeah.
And the current's 5 miles an hour.
She goes 12. The current is pushing her a little bit. The total is 19. So what must this current be? 31.
Yeah.
31.
Whatever
Shelby says. She can paddle 19 or paddle 12. The current is pushing her a little bit. It's helping her along. Helps her to the point of getting to 19 miles per hour. So how fast?
She's already paddling.
Mm-hmm.
She's going with the current. It's
19
miles an hour.
I'm not saying the current is 19 miles an hour. Her speed is 19 miles an hour.
Well, with the river, it's 19, right?
Yes, her speed
is
along with
the
river.
She's going
the
same way.
What's that?
The current would be, the current would be going 13.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
She would
why
be going 13?
She's going 12.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so she's going 12.
You add 5.
Yeah.
9 will equal 17.
Dude, I have a legit question. I keep getting after something.
Okay.
Question.
Okay. So she's going 12 miles an hour, and she's going with the river, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's also traveling 19.
No, it's not traveling 19.
Well, she's going
if
with
you were
the
standing
river
on the side of the river, and you watched her go by, you measured her speed. Her speed would be 19 miles per hour.
It's not like stacking.
The total speed
the
is 19.
So
it's
you
like
say
like
12 plus
itself
something equals 19. And that's 7.
So the speed of the river must be 7. Or x is 12 plus y equals 19. This is exactly what we were doing like in our heads. Subtract 12 from both sides and y is 7. We can do the same thing with this equation. 12 minus y equals 5. And we can solve for y that way. Either way, we're going to find out that y is
7.
So adding an equation to another equation is the main idea here, that we can add one equation to another equation. So let's do it again.
The real basic one, like
2x plus y equals 4, and x minus y equals 2x plus y equals 4, and x minus y equals 5. So what we've established is that you can add two equations together. Because if on this side I add 5, right? If on this side I add 4 and 5, I get 9. Well, I just added 5 to this side of the equation, so over here I have to add 5 or something equal to 5, and this is equal to 5, so I can add these two together. What's 2x plus x?
2x. No, just 2x. X plus x.
2x plus
3x.
3x. So y minus y?
Nothing.
Nothing, so y, you're going to write it. 3x equals 9. So x equals?
3.
3. X equals 3. Put 3 there. 2 times 3 plus y equals 4. 6 plus y equals 4. So y equals?
8.
We'll subtract 6 from both sides. 4 minus 6 is negative 2. Again, 5x plus 2y is 9, 3x minus 2y equals 32, or no, it equals 23. I can add two equations together. I can add the number size together, the variable size together. 9 plus 23 is what?
32.
5x plus 3x? 8.
8x.
2y plus negative 2y?
It cancels each other out. To
cancels each other out. So 8x equals 32, and x equals?
4.
If x equals 4, then I'll use this equation here. 5
four.
Times 4 plus 2y equals 9. 20 plus 2y equals 9. 2y equals negative 11. 5 by 2, y equals negative 11 and a half. So the solution to this system is 4 and negative. It's called elimination. I'll give it a try. Let's see, let's use one I can be sure is going to work out nicely. Negative 3x. Let's write this one in our notes. Negative 7, negative 4x plus 5y equals 14. So we're going to add both sides together. We're going to add these sides together. We're going to get negative 7 plus 14 is? 7. Negative 3x minus 4x.
Negative
5y plus 5y.
Cancels each other out.
Cancels each other out. Negative 7x equals 7. Divide by negative 7, and x is?
Negative
1. Now we know that x is negative 1, so plug in one of these equations. Stop talking. Look up here, as I've asked you to do several times. Please pay attention. I get tired of talking to a room full of talking people, and the next day they say, well, I don't even get it. Pay attention. Okay? That equation, negative 3 times x, which x we know is negative 1, plus 5y, actually minus 5y. No, I'm using this equation. So negative 4 times x, which you know is negative 1, plus 5y equals 14. So negative 4 times negative 1 is 4, plus 5y. 14, subtract 4 from both sides, 5y equals 10, divide by 5, y is 2, negative 1, 2. No. Next time, let's do it. Oh, no, not going to get there. Let's try this equation, 2, well, let's see, I want it to work out nicely, so let me pick one that works out nicely already. 2x minus y equals 32. Y minus 5x equals 13.
So mine did work somehow, but it didn't get the right.
Let's see, if I add the right sides together, what do I get? 45. And the left side. Can I add all the stuff together? The way that these were lined up like this, it's just convenient. But we are forcing ourselves to only combine like terms, right?
Yes.
As long as we combine like terms, we can do this. Right? Can I add these sides together? Well, can I add 2x to y?
No.
I can't add y's and x's, but can I add x's and x's? Are there some x's to add?
Yes, there's
5x. There's negative 5x to add. So 2x minus 5x.
It'll be negative
3x. Negative y plus y?
That's just nothing.
It's just nothing? So divide by negative 3 and x is negative 15. So if x is negative 15, we can plug that into either of these equations to figure out what y is, like the second one. Y minus 5 times negative 15 equals 13. Y negative times negative is positive, it's positive 75 equals 13. Subtract 75 on both sides. Y equals negative. If I want it to look nice and have it line up, we can have it line up by switching these guys around. You can rearrange this equation so that the x's come first and the y's come second, because when you add things together, it doesn't really matter what order they're in, as long as their signs follow them around as they should. So I'll just take this and I'll rearrange it. I'll put the negative 5x first, plus y. I'm just writing it so it looks nicer before I get exactly the same thing as I did here. If I add these together, I'm going to get negative 3x, right? I'm going to get 0y, and I'm going to get